This conference will now be recorded.
Okay.
Nikhil, you there? Nikhil?
Hi, Shrikant. Hi, everybody.
Yeah, hi.
Hi. Okay. So maybe we can start, right?
Yes, Shrikant, go ahead, please.
Thank you. Then, okay, let us close all the tabs to the right. So today, myself, Shrikant, I have 8+ years of experience in Salesforce as an admin, developer, app builder, and as an integration consultant. And currently I work for a leading bank as a Salesforce lead in Malaysia. Fine. So that's about me. So today we are here about to have a small demonstration on Salesforce. So yeah, few of you might be a fresh graduate and few of you might be a 10-year experienced Java developer. So considering the background of all the students, we will try to, the tone of today's discussion will be at a beginner level. So we will try to discuss the things in a much more simpler way. We'll try to make the things as simple as possible. So wherever you have doubts, please don't stop me. Please don't hesitate. Please stop me right away. Fine. So yeah. Okay. So please don't hesitate. This is just a friendly interaction. You can stop me whenever you want if you have any doubt. Fine. So yeah, let's start. So first question, like, what is Salesforce? Okay, so let's start with this basic question. So what is Salesforce? So I would define Salesforce as a cloud-based CRM application. Fine. So I would define Salesforce as a cloud-based CRM application. So here we need to spend some time on each of these keywords. So what is cloud? What is CRM? And then what is application? So let us spend some five minutes of time to understand these keywords very clearly. Fine. So what is Salesforce? Salesforce is a cloud-based CRM application. So then what is cloud? Okay. So cloud, okay, the textual definition is cloud refers to over the internet, the phenomenon of processing, managing, handling the data on a, which is stored on a server, which is hosted over the internet. Okay, those textual definitions. Let us put all those things aside. Let's talk in a easier language. Okay, so what is cloud? For example, right now, if I give you the mouse control, okay, so you people have joined using some link, right? So I mean, for the go-to meeting, right now, if I give you some mouse control, you people can access, let's say, any of the application that you can see on my screen, correct? So of the
Shrikant, you are so breaking a little bit, Shrikant.
And your web browser you are using with that.
Shrikant, you are breaking. I don't know if it's me or everyone.
No, for me also.
Okay. Let me. So now I guess it should be fine. Okay, shall we go ahead?
Yeah, go ahead, please.
Okay, to understand the keyword cloud. Okay, so right now, if I give you the mouse control, you can open my VLC media player and you can play some video. Fine. So my laptop in which the VLC media player was installed, okay, my laptop will become the server for you. Whatever the Chrome browser you are using, by which you have you are just executing that go-to meeting link, okay, so that Chrome browser will become a client. Fine. So yeah, you are under the client side. My laptop will become a server through this link, and through over the, I mean, because of that mouse control, you are able to access the applications that are on my desktop. So in this process, if you observe carefully, in order to access any cloud-based application, we just need an internet, we just need internet connectivity and a browser. We just need internet connectivity and a browser. Fine. So, any application. Okay. For example, Google is also a cloud computing company. Salesforce is also a cloud computing company. Fine. So if I go here, if I click here, click on these 9 dots. So all these are the applications launched by Google. In order to access any of the application that is available here, you just need an internet connectivity and a browser. Fine. So in order to access any application, whether it is YouTube, Google Map, any application. So all these applications are cloud-based applications. So the difference, the difference between a cloud-based application and a standalone application is, if you are downloading a setup file and installing in your laptop, then such an application will be a standalone application to you. Fine. So such an application will be a standalone application to you. For example, the same VLC media player is a standalone application to me because I have downloaded that setup file, I have installed it in my C drive. That's the reason I was able to access it. So the same VLC media player is a standalone application to me, whereas it will become a cloud-based application to you because you people are not installing anything in order to access my VLC media player. Fine. So in the similar way, so that's all about cloud. Fine. So any application, so going further in Salesforce, whatever the application that we will be using, okay, consuming, fine, all applications are cloud-based applications. You just need an internet connectivity and a browser. It is as simple as logging into our Gmail account. Okay, you will be given some credentials, you will be logging into Salesforce and start using it. Fine. So it is, you just need internet connectivity and a browser. So that's all about cloud. Okay, that's all about the keyword cloud. Fine. Then what is application? Okay, so the discussion about CRM is a lengthy story. So let's complete application first. Application keyword. So what is application? So as far as Salesforce is concerned, an application can be defined as group of objects, tabs, and its functionalities. Okay, group of objects, tabs. So group of objects, tabs, and its functionalities. Right. So group of objects, tabs, and its functionalities. Okay, apart from this, blah, 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 that textual definition. So let us talk something that we already know. Okay, so consider an application called WhatsApp. Fine. So WhatsApp is a tab-based application. Fine. Of course, it's a mobile application, but yes. So WhatsApp is a tab-based application. It has 3 tabs. Chat, let's say chat, status, and call logs. Correct. So it has 3 tabs. So each tab is a self-existing independent entity. So what I'm trying to say is, like, whenever I delete one of my call logs in my WhatsApp, that doesn't affect or erase any data that is available in the chat. Fine. So each tab points to a database table. Each tab is linked to a database table. So each tab has some purpose, has some predefined purpose. So whenever we bundle up all these 3 tabs, it becomes a meaningful application called WhatsApp. Fine. It becomes a meaningful application called, in the similar way, all the applications that we develop in Salesforce are tab-based applications. Fine. So we will be building few tabs. Each tab will be linked to a table. We will be storing some data. Then on the top of this architecture, we will be automating our business process. Fine. So yeah, application in Salesforce are tab-based applications. Similar to what we see, we will be having some tab bar, few tabs will be there. Clear? So yeah. So wherever you have any doubt, so please don't hesitate. Yeah. So please stop me right away. So this is all about cloud and application. Let's spend some 5 to 10 minutes of time on CRM. Fine. So what is the CRM? Okay. So of course, like most of you might be knowing, CRMs, obviously stands for customer relationship management. Okay. So relationship management. Okay, so that's fine. But let us try to spend some time on discussing about like what reasons in a running business have demanded for these new breed of application called CRM apps. CRM app, CRM tool, CRM software, whatever it is. So what reasons in the running business, in a running business, have given rise, have demanded for this new breed of applications called CRM? Okay, so in order to understand that better, so let's discuss in a small story. Fine. For example, I have started a company. Okay, my company is a new company, it's a startup. Fine. So my job is to sell laptops, laptop manufacturing company. I have started a company. So basically I manufacture laptops, I sell them. I sell them and make some money. Fine. So this is my plan. So right now, let's say 1,000 laptops I have already manufactured. They are in my godown. So the next immediate thing, I mean, obviously I'll be doing is my goal is to sell them and make some money. Fine. So in order to understand CRM, let us take a small example that I have started a business, a startup, laptop manufacturing company, 1,000 laptops I have in my hand. Fine. So first step that I'll be doing is, with a product in my hand, I will do promotion. Correct. So I'll do promotion. So what type of promotion? Whether it could be paper ad, banner ad, or mass email marketing, or any kind of hoarding, or a webinar, or any stall in a shopping mall, fine, any kind of. So let us stick to banner ad. Okay, banner ad in the sense of hoarding an LED screen or a banner across the street. Okay, so this is what banner ad implies. Let's consider one form of promotion called banner ad. Okay, we have fixed one form of promotion, that is banner ad. So that is, we are going to hold LED screen in a busy road. So next thing is, you have to pick top 10 cities in the country. Okay, top 10 cities in the country. Then you have to pick in each city top 10 streets. Fine, top 10 streets. Okay. On what basis we are going to define it as a top 10? I mean, what is the criteria? You might ask me about, Srikanth, on what criteria you are picking it as a top 10? Okay, so the criteria is, let's say at least 2,000 people cross the street per day. At least 2,000 people cross the street per day. Then I'm considering it as one of the busy street. So that way, this is the filter. Okay. So the next thing is, okay, today is it 12th of May. So let's assume from 1st of June, our plan is from 1st of June to 31st of June. So in all these selected streets, we are going to hold our LED screen or a banner in the front of the screen, I mean in the front of the street and at the end of the street, at the start and at the end of the street. Okay, fine. Let's assume that, this is how the statistics are. On June 1st, after completion of the day one of our promotion, out of 2,000 people who crossed one street, pick up a particular street. Let's say only 20 people gave me a call. Okay, so 20 people gave me a call, like they are interested in our product. Okay, our banner contains what are the features that we can offer and how it is different from other marketplaces and local branch office number. Only 20 people gave a call. So now, After these 20 people go, we call it as initial inquiries. Initial inquiries. After getting these 20 contact numbers, the job of our voice process team starts. Okay, voice process team. So we will force our voice process team to give them a follow-up call multiple times. Fine. And we will ask our voice process team to identify how many of these 20 people are genuine buyers. For example, I'll go to a shopping mall, I will try different shirts, but I might not buy any shirt. Fine. So maybe a window shopping kind of thing. So what I'm trying to say is, not all people who approached you, they need not be a serious buyers. So the job of our voice process team is to identify, to filter out those serious buyers. Fine. So for example, if you give them a call tomorrow, they might say phone switch off, or they'll say I'm out of station, or call me after 1 week, or they will not pick the call. Fine. So multiple things can happen. Fine. So let's say five people are okay. So yeah, five people. Our Salesforce team have filtered out five people. So these five people, we call it as technically, we call it as opportunities. Fine. Opportunities. So these five opportunities. Now somehow I have a clarity that these five people have money in their pocket. Fine. So if I convince them, they will buy my laptop. So somehow three out of five people, we convinced them, and these three people were converted into our customers. So the revenue was generated for our company, and money was into my pocket. Fine. I have sold my records. Then how about the other two people? If I am thinking in a similar way, my competitor will also think in the same way, other laptop sellers. So I have lost those two leads to my competitors. My competitors deal with the customers in a better way than me, so that I have lost those two guys. Right? So at the end of the day, what I expect you people to understand here is, out of 2,000 people per day, the conversion ratio is just 3. Fine. So technically, we call it as sales funnel. So this 2,000 was squeezed down ultimately to 3 people. We call it as, these MBA guys, management people, call it as sales funnel. Fine. Okay, well, we will sell a laptop. That's great. Now, for a small business, okay, for a running business, any business, whether it is a laptop or a cell phone product, doesn't matter. This is a typical sales process that happens in any org. Fine. So how to speed up my business process so that my conversion ratio is high? How to speed up my business process is the question. This is where the people felt like, if we have a new breed of application called CRM apps, which will help us to automate or speed up my business process so that my conversion ratio will be high. If it is a sales department, fine. If it is a service department, complaints will be low. Fine. If it is a sales department, conversion rate will be high. So how, Srikanth, you'll ask me about, okay, you said, okay, in order to speed up this sales cycle, you want me to use a CRM application, but how it will speed up the business process? Okay, if that is your question, then think about how you're going to handle 2,000 people per day per street. Think about how you're going to handle these 2,000 people per day per 10 streets. How about 2,000 people per day per 10 cities, 2,000 people per 30 days per 10 streets in 10 cities. So on a larger scale, we don't want any delay in this sales process. Okay. So in order to handle, manage all these things, we need a specific software which will help us to speed up our business process. So now that's the reason. These are the reasons which demanded for this new breed of application to speed up our business process, to automate our business process, so that customers will be happy. Fine. For example, out of these three people who bought a laptop with me, after 6 months, they gave me a call, Srikanth, speaker is not working in your laptop. So I should solve those issues as quickly as possible. Correct. So So this CRM application will speed up my business process so that I can maintain the relationship with my customer in a proper way. Okay, so define CRM. CRM applications are used to maintain the relationship with my customer in a proper way by automating my business process. Automating in sense, by speeding up my business process so that the feedback from the customers will be good and reviews will be good, and which will indirectly affect my, which will indirectly improve my revenue of the company. Fine. So these are the reasons. Okay, we understood. Okay, now you might say like, yeah, we understood the purpose of CRM. Then what's next? So Salesforce is one of the many companies who offers CRM CRM applications. Okay, so what are the other market players? Why today we are learning about Salesforce? So the other market players are Zoho, Siebel CRM, Sugar CRM, Microsoft Dynamics CRM. These are the other market players who offers the same kind of Same kind of instance, yeah, they are into CRM domain. So Microsoft Dynamics CRM. And nowadays, a lot of buzz is happening on this CRM, Zendesk. Aajkal popular ho gaya. Yeah, so Zendesk. These are the other marketplaces. But the question is, why we are learning Salesforce? But why not Zoho, let's say Sugar, Zendesk are not as popular as Salesforce? Okay, so let us talk about it for 1 minute. First reason is, there are three releases that happens in a year. Okay. In the sense, summer, winter, spring. Okay, so summer, winter, spring. So for every 3 months, for every 4 months, Salesforce is going to release a new version of it. Okay, new version is says it may not be a drastic change completely, but yes, a new version of Salesforce will be released. So what are the changes that they have done for the existing version? They will release a version booklet. So these other companies are not as alert as Salesforce. These other technologies are not as quick as Salesforce to cope up with the market standard in such a way that for every 3 months, this technology get new modules or some kind of new update. Fine. So that's the first reason. And second reason is, if there is anything surprise or new in the market, Salesforce will adopt that technology to itself and they will improve their CRM product. For example, I can give you two examples. In the year 2012 to 2014, the buzz of artificial intelligence was like increasing in the market. So immediately Salesforce has released a module called Salesforce Einstein. Salesforce Einstein. So that around 3 weeks ago, around 10 days to 15 days ago, using Salesforce Einstein, there is a new product called e-commerce cloud. There is a new product called commerce cloud. A new feature in commerce cloud was launched in such a way, like whenever you are walking on a street, if a person is crossing you, if you like his shirt, just take a photo snapshot, just take a pic of his shirt and try to upload it into e-commerce site, so that Einstein artificial intelligence module will sense the color and the type of the cloth and the design, and exactly similar kind of shirt will be pulled from the Amazon and it will be shown onto your screen so that you can buy that shirt then and there itself. Fine. So these kind of most advanced artificial intelligence tools are not yet available in other market players. I can give another example, very good example. In the year 2016, there was a revolutionary product in the market called Amazon smart speakers. Okay, smart speakers. So smart speakers, in the sense, let's say there is hi Alexa, play this song. So hi Alexa, play this song. So whenever you say, Alexa used to play some song, right? Amazon smart speakers. So hi Alexa, play some song, it just plays it, right? The same kind of smart speaker strategy was implemented in Salesforce. So on last September 30, 2018, fine. So whenever there is something new, Salesforce adopts to itself. Fine. So these other marketplaces are not as fast as 2018. So currently this product was announced and it is under pilot testing for the trusted customers. It is not available for the end users. So yeah, so now whenever you say hi Einstein, create a contact, if you verbally say it, it will create a contact for yourself. There is no need for you to type like name, email, phone number, all those things, and create a contact. So when you can talk with the CRM, so CRM will schedule the meeting, send email, it just can send the create the records, it can retrieve the records, so it can create events. So all these things can happen. So it is not yet launched to the end customers, but it is under pilot testing. So these other technologies are not as good as Salesforce in this aspect. That's the reason we are learning Salesforce. Fine. So, Okay. Having said that, wherever you have doubts, please stop me. Please never hesitate. Okay. Okay. Yeah, so let's go ahead. Why Salesforce is special, we have learned, but what Salesforce can offer. Okay, let us see what Salesforce can offer. So Salesforce can offer two types of services. Okay, Salesforce is a cloud computing company. It can offer two types of services. So the first service is ready-made applications. I'm trying to make the things as simple as possible. Ready-made applications. In the sense, few applications were already built by Salesforce. Considering this commonly used sales pattern in any organization, this kind of sales pattern, considering this sales pattern, so Salesforce have a few ready-made applications. In a sense, they are inbuilt applications, standard applications. You can try it for 30 days. If you like it, pay the Salesforce per credential and start using it for your business. It is as simple as that. Fine. So try it for 30 days. Let's say there is an application called sales app, service app, marketing app, commerce app, multiple applications are there. So instead of calling them as app, because all the applications are cloud-based applications, so people got used to call them as cloud, not just app. Okay. So people got used to call them as sales cloud, service cloud, marketing cloud, etc. So all these are the standard applications, inbuilt applications. Salesforce are selling them directly. If you like it, try it for 30 days. If you feel like, yeah, they are suitable for your business, then start using them directly. Okay, yeah. Textually, yeah, verbal, I mean, technically, people call it as software as a service. It is quite simple. It is just a ready-made application they are providing. If you like it, pay them and use it. Yeah. So the first type of service Salesforce provides us is software as a service. Yeah, people call it as software as a service. So no need to worry about these technical terms as of today. The second type of service Salesforce offers is platform as a, okay, forget about platform as a service. So second type of service Salesforce offers is, okay, you might ask me doubt, Srikanth, I tried Sales Cloud. I felt that it is almost okay. I want to change 10% of Sales Cloud. I want to tweak Sales Cloud so that it will be in sync with my business process. So if you want to do that 10 to 30, let's say some percentage of change, some kind of change, if you want to tweak the existing application, yes, it is possible. It is possible. Salesforce provides us the facility that you can tweak the existing application and you can try to use it for yourself. Okay, that is case one. You want to change a little bit and you want to use it. And case two, if you like this application, start using it directly. If you want to make changes, yes, facility is there. If I'm going too fast, too slow, please let me know. I will tune the screenplay. Fine. Okay. Yeah, so let's go ahead. Okay, I'm not at all happy with the existing application. I really don't like it. I want to build my own application from scratch, from 0%. I want to build my own application. Is it possible? Yes, it is possible. Salesforce provides us a facility to build our own application from 0%. So no need to borrow the 90% and change the 10% and use it for your business. Okay. You can do it from 0%. Yeah. So technically, yeah, people call it as platform as a service. Even this one, technically, people call it as software as a service. Fine. Yeah. So technically, people call it as platform as a service. Okay. So okay, let's compare with what we already know, because I always believe in learning something with what we already know. For example, for cloud-based, we have tried to use that VLC one example. For CRM, we took a startup. For application, we took a start WhatsApp. Right? So it will be quite easier to remember, no? Okay. So let us compare with what we already know. For example, the sibling of Salesforce, I mean, Salesforce is a cloud computing company. Google is also a cloud computing company. For example, can you create your own application which is similar to Gmail with some 10% changes and rename it with your company website? Does Google allow to do that? No, Google doesn't allow you to do that. You can't clone this Gmail and you can't put your own name with some 10% changes and you can't display it in this app bar. Not possible. Because this is a ready-made application, this is a locked application. Of course, utmost thing you can do is change the background wallpaper. Apart from that, you can't customize much. You can't, this is a locked application. You can't change the core functionality. For example, can you place this inbox button instead of right side? Can you place this on the left side? Or can I write some code? Does Google allow me to write some code so that I can create this inbox button in the bottom left corner? Can I shift this compose button to the bottom left corner? Yes, I'm ready to write any kind of program. Not possible. Correct. Why? Yeah, that's what I said. So comparatively, Google provides only software as a service. They provide ready-made applications. They don't provide this 10-20% changes. Neither they provide this kind of, yeah. So nor they provide a complete platform to create your own application from scratch. Fine. So that is what about software as a service and platform as a service. Okay. So then what's next? Whenever I say tweaking an application or developing an application from scratch, there are two ways by which you can develop an application or enhance an existing application. One is declarative way of development. Okay, declarative way of development. So you can develop an application to some extent without writing a single line of code, through just configuration, through out of work functionality, through drag and drop tools. Okay, so declarative way of development. Fine. Okay, I call it as admin. Okay, Salesforce admin. So Salesforce admin is supposed to know, the one who is aiming to become a Salesforce administrator. Yeah, so he's supposed to know all these, all the concepts of declarative way of development. Fine. And if it is really tough to quench the client requirement, if it is really tough to complete the client requirement without writing, with a declarative way of development, then you have to go for programmatic way. Okay. So programmatic, P-R-O-G, yeah, program. I'm very bad. After my 10th, I'm very bad at spelling. Yeah. So programmatic way of development. Fine. So programmatic. Okay, so here we have classic and lightning. Classic and lightning. Fine. Yeah. So yeah, these are the two ways by which you can develop the application. Okay, lot of things from past half an hour, paper. So we have seen lot of paper. So let's do something practical. Fine. So let's do some whatever we have discussed till now. Let's visualize it once so that we will remember it. Okay, so what is step number one? So okay, what is the first step, Srikanth? First step for an absolute beginner is go to developer.salesforce.com. This is the URL. So create an account. It is as simple as creating your Gmail account. So create an account. You will be given some login credentials. Okay. So it is as simple as logging in into your Gmail. Fine. So okay, that will be the first step. So let's do that now. Developer bot. This is my blog. So I do keep writing some articles. So on Salesforce. So you can just go through it. Yeah, this is my blog. Okay. So apart from that, developer.salesforce.com. So click on sign up. OK, Okay, so you need to provide all these credentials. Okay. Just a moment. I was instructed by the management. Just a moment. I'll fill up the form. You'll get an email. Just a moment. Just a moment. I'm just filling up the form with the details. Okay. It contains a name, phone number, email, all those things. I mean, yeah. So apart from that, nothing will be there. So 50470 is the pin code. Okay. Sorry for that. So now username. So you have to provide, I mean, username should be something at the company name.com. For example, mine 1950, let's say at 1950 at sfdc.com, something at the company name.com. So click on sign up. Okay, so now next thing is click here. So then click on verify email. So provide some password. So cloud123. Okay. So click on continue. Fine. So we will be logged in into Salesforce. So this is our Salesforce account. So first is first, let's observe the URL. So what does it contain? So AP50. So what does it mean? AP15 in the sense, Salesforce is a cloud-based application and my application is hosted on Asia Pacific server number 15. Instance number 15. Okay, so if you are a US based student, if you try to log in into developer org, you will get NA 54, NA 45, North America 54, 45. Okay, fine. So, sorry. So, yeah, that is all about AP 50. Then, what is this lightning? Okay, so Salesforce have two user interfaces. Fine. So two user interfaces, Lightning and Classic. At the end of the lecture, we will talk about difference between Lightning and Classic. So I mean, for now, you can consider like, yeah, there are two themes. You can consider like there are, as a beginner, yeah, we can consider like there are two themes by which you can interact with Salesforce. This is the Lightning theme, and if you go here, switch to Classic. So this is the classic thing. So this is the classic thing. Okay. So in Google, we have these 9 dots where all the list of applications will be shown. Correct. In the similar way, we have logged in into our Salesforce account. This is the app access panel, similar to that 9 dots in Salesforce. Right. So content, sales, service, marketing, all these are the standard applications. All these are the standard applications. No need to worry about them as of first lecture. Sales cloud, service cloud. They are like 1 or 2 hours topics in our syllabus. So don't worry about all those things. I'm just picking up all the touch points that is the motive of our 48 hours of training. Fine. So don't worry about all those things. Elaborate discussion will be done when we start our sales cloud topic, so don't worry about it. So just a brief idea. Yes, this is all about app access. You know, all these are the ready-made applications. Okay. So for example, let's go to sales app. As similar to WhatsApp, so this is the tab bar. Tab bar, fine. It contains all the list of tabs. Each tab has some purpose, some feature, some functionality. Okay. So if we can learn, if we can understand the purpose of each and every tab available here, you can sit for Sales Cloud Consultant certification. Okay, you can pass the exam as well. Sales Cloud Consultant. Fine. Okay. So out of all these tabs, for now, I want to touch only one tab, that is contact. Okay, we all know the purpose of contact. It is used, it is as similar to what we do in our phone, mobile phone, in our phone book. It is just, okay. So whenever you click on contact and hit on go, all the list of contacts will be shown. Now you might ask me about, okay, Srikant, this is a fresh org. From where we got these 20 records? These are the sample records the Salesforce gives for testing purpose. No need to worry about it. You can delete that. Okay, so this is how, this is what a table. So whenever you click a chat, you'll get the list of, chat, right? Recent chat, okay. Until unless you do, you won't delete them. Then similarly, these are the list of contacts. Fine. So now, okay, yeah, we can create a new contact. That's fine. That's great. For example, I want to give some demo about this one. 10% changes in the existing application. If you want to tweak the existing application, how to do it? Declarative way. There are two ways. I want to talk about this declarative way as of today. So declarative way, for example, my client said, Srikant, currently in my running business, I don't capture the date of birth of the contact. I take mobile phone. I don't take the phone fax. I don't take assistant number. Just hide these things, Srikant. For example, as a Salesforce developer, client asked me, Srikant, as per my business process, we don't want these list of fields. How to hide them? There is no need for you to do anything programmatically. Click here. Click on edit layout. Yeah, Nikhil. So do you want to show something? Any doubt?
No, sorry. I just clicked.
It's okay. Sorry. I understood. Sorry. Yeah. Okay. So let's go ahead. Okay. Quite simple. If you want to hide the field, just drag and drop. Declarative. No need to write any code. And to be frank, out of the 20 plus projects exposure that I have, any project may, you can complete 60 to 70% of the project without writing single line of code. Trust me, this is correct. Okay, out of my 20 plus project exposure. Okay, so 60 to 70% of the project you can complete without writing a single line of code. Okay, so utna, that much level of control we have. That's the beauty of Salesforce. That much level of control we have, even without writing single line of code, I can configure the application. For example, click here, go to edit layout. Okay, if you don't like this field, drag it, drop it in the panel. Done. It is not deleted. Conditions apply. It is not deleted. It is just hidden from the page. Drag it, drop it. Drag it, drop it. Very simple. Even a 10th standard student can do this. Admin is very easy. Even a 10th standard student can clear admin certification. Fine. 15-year-old student can clear admin certification. Very simple admin. So just simple drag and drop. That's the reason. Okay. So because I can guarantee you, like after our admin lectures, you will be equivalent to at least 3 to 5 years experience of administrator. Why? Because in order to hide a field, even if it is you who learned it today, right now, or even if it is a 10-year experience administrator, everyone has to do the same. So how does it matter if you say your manager that you have learned it today or you have learned it 5 years ago? Fine. So the concepts of admin are simple drag and drop functionality. Once you learn it, you have learned it forever.
Thanks for making that simple, Srikant.
What happened?
Because I'm going to become admin, so thanks for letting me know.
Okay. So because how does it matter? Yeah, even if it is a 10-year experience administrator, na, they have to hide field hide karne ke liye, this is the step. You can't escape from clicking on edit layout. So how does it matter whether you say you have learned it right now or whether you have learned it 5 years ago? How does it matter? Fine. So yeah, that's it. Admin tasks are quite fixed. They are monotonous. So if we learn it once, yeah, we are equivalent to expert admin. Fine. So that's the beauty of admin. Easily admin jobs, we can easily crack it. So yeah, no worries about it. Having said that, okay. So the next thing is, okay, so programmatically, okay, this is all about admin. For example, if you want to create a dropdown, how to create it? Quickly, I will show you, but don't worry about it. This is just a simple demo lecture. I'm giving you the taste and flavor of all the topics. So don't worry about it. Elaborate discussion will be done later. So click here on view fields and go to pick list. Then click on next. Then so let's say you want to store contact, you know? So contact me, let's say state. So all the 29 states in the country, in whichever the country we stay. So let's say AP, TN, like MH, whatever it is. So I'm adding some place fillers. So you can give all the list of 29 states and click on next, 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 and say done. So next, 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 and done. So you have created, right? Now reload this page. You can find that state field here. Fine. So whatever we have, this is a dropdown. Clear. So this is how we can create the field. So most of the, I mean, a project can be completed without a single line of code. Okay. So this is all about tweaking the existing application. Whatever the 10% changes, you can remove a field, hide a field, create a field, those kind of small, small things. Security, yeah, few other things are there. Yeah, a brief flavor about it. How to create a new application. For example, hit on setup, then click on add app. Step number one, remember it. Hit on setup, how to create an application, custom application. Very, very important, 5-star question, okay. So hit on setup, then click on add app. Hit on add app, then name your application. For example, I want to build an application for the hospital. So that hospital receptionist, accountants, all the fee collectors, so those guys will be using my application for speeding up their business process. Okay. So this is a hospital management system. So I'll be giving the login credentials for the management staff, the receptionist, and all those people. So they will use this application internally, okay, to speed up their business process. And the first tab is, let's say, patients. P-A-T-I-E-N-T-S. So just paste it here. Done. So click on create. Done. It is as very simple. Application is created. Okay, now if you scroll down, you can see a new item here, hospital management system. So click on this hospital management system. We have a new, we have a new tab called patient. Purpose of this patient is, as of now, this has only one column called patient name, but gradually, eventually, I have shown you, right, how to create a field. So click here, click new, you will be creating multiple fields. Admission date, joining date, fee, what is a disorder, in which room number, what is address, phone number, all those things. So now we'll be hitting on save. How do we speed up business process by using this application? If power cut or due to any reason, even in your mobile phone, if a random person, stranger, reach a reception in the hospital and ask like, I want to know where this patient was admitted, in which room. So if a random, then our receptionist will type the patient name in the quick search, in the global search bar. So if a random person attend the reception and ask me like, I want to know about this patient, I will be searching in the global search bar. All the details of the patient will be shown to me and I'll be telling them like, yes, patient is admitted in room number 50. These are the details of the patient. This much is due, balance, so all this. This is how you are going to speed up the business process, right? Okay. So fine. So yeah, this is about creating custom applications. You can extend the feature. For example, your client said, I'll give you one demo that is available in another app regarding this programmatic way of development. After that, FAQs will be there. Like, yeah, you people can ask me any question, any doubt, anything. Any concerns regarding, completely regarding Salesforce, you can ask me anything regarding Salesforce, then we will close it off. So I want to show the demo for development, pure development. POC at zero.com. Okay. So let's say I'm running a recruitment business. Okay. So my job is to send my employees to the client location. Fine. Or let's say any internal, okay, whatever it is. So for this contact record, if this contact is my employee, okay, I will be creating all these fields. Okay, this kind of fields and all. Fine. I can click on generate offer letter, generate experience letter. So So this kind of paperwork will be, this kind of paperwork will be generated. What I'm trying to say is, any kind of document, any kind of paper document that you want to officially release from the company, whether it is an offer letter, payslip, experience letter, or any sales agreement, construction agreement, memorandum of understanding, any piece of paper, instead of writing in Excel sheet, instead of editing them, instead of playing hours of time, so you can create a record and you can click on a single button that will generate all these things. Okay, if you click on offer letter for the internal employee, you can distribute this offer letter. So not only offer letter, if it is a case of patient, you can generate a medical bill, place a button here, click here, a PDF will be generated, medical bill. You can have another button, you can send an email to the customer. This is how all these GoIBIBO, all these travel agencies, Redbus, all these things work. How do they send emails? Through CRMs, they do that. Fine. Email alerts, SMS alerts, whenever we book a bus, 5 hours before the bus, journey, 1 hour before, how do they do it? Using these CRMs. They use CRM for sure. Of course, it may or may not be Salesforce, but yes, they use some kind of CRM to do all these things. This is how they are speeding up their business process. Travel agencies here. So right now we are seeing hospital management. This is a recruitment here. So where was that? Yeah, we can generate this kind of offer letter. You can just take a print and give it to the, instead of manually editing it, all these things. Fine. So those fields, whatever the data that is there here, all these fields are brought up programmatically here. Okay. So this is one of the demonstration that I can provide for programmatic way of development. Fine. Okay. So far, so good. Yeah, obviously these PPTs are there. Yeah, you will be material ke liye, no need to worry about material. Plenty of material is there. So the same thing, whatever I spoke there, what is cloud computing, so textual definitions, so all these things are there. So you can work up on them. So don't worry about materials, lot of material there. So software as a service, platform as a service. Okay, so you can see software as a service. I said it as a ready-made application, but these guys say it as, textual definition is cloud provider leases an application, gives it for rent to its client. So both are same, no? Okay, so now if you have any doubts, any concerns, anything regarding Salesforce, next 5 minutes, mein agar kuch hai toh, you can ask me. I'll try to express my views on it.
What kind of background do you need for programmatically, you know, if you're doing changes or development, Srikant?
Background, if it is my class, no prerequisite required. No prerequisite required. Just come up with empty mind. I will fill it up with Salesforce. Fine. No prerequisite requires. Yes, we have students who are, of course, thoda hard work, thoda sa mehnat to karna hi padega. So for non-IT background students, they have to work hard. Of course, anyone has to work hard, okay, because development is like swimming. It is not like admin. By watching admin lectures, you can clear admin interview. But for development, you can't say like how to swim. We can't read a book like how to swim, and we can't swim, right? So in the similar way, until unless you write
logic, we cannot explain while loop kaise chalta.
Correct. So until unless you start writing your code, Okay, so I mean, we until now is you people start. Toda sa hard work is to be required from your side. Until unless you start writing your code, we can't become a very good developer. So that's about development. Hai. And so prerequisite, no prerequisite.
Yeah. Because what is the programming language we are using here?
Programming language, I'll try to explain in simple terms. Okay, so let's for all other students as well, I'll try to frame a small story. So let's assume I have a WhatsApp. Fine. Front end me, I was able to see that green color screen. Correct. So every application can be generally broken up into three parts. That WhatsApp may have a green color screen, right? So in that is a front end screen. Then we will be having a postman. Okay, every application can be divided into three parts. First part is front end screen, and second part is database. Database in sense the place where our chat, status, all those things are stored. Okay, that is database. And there is someone called postman. I mean, the one who does the job of a postman. Okay, what is the job of a postman? He will be having some letters and postcards. Like a courier service, he will be passing the data from the source to destination. Yes, exactly. There is a middleman. There is a person called whose role is like a postman. Whenever you click on a call tab, the third tab in WhatsApp, this postman is running towards the database, knocking the door of a table called call, and it is pulling all the rows of that are available in the table and bundling it up, running back towards the screen, this postman, and spitting it on, throwing it on the screen. All these things are happening in that 1 microsecond, 1 millisecond of the time. So any application can be broken up into three parts. So whenever you type a chat, even this postman will, whatever the form you are filling, whatever the chat you are filling and sending a message, this postman will capture that message, throw it in the database, and as well as pass it to your friend. Of course, that's a byproduct. That's another chain of actions. So no need to worry about it. So what I'm trying to say, the role of this postman is pass the data from screen to storage, storage to screen. Now, technically, let's talk what kind of technologies we will use, Shrikant, in the sense. For screens, if you are using a classic theme, that language is Visual Force. It is similar to HTML, and no need to learn HTML in order to learn Visual Force. And this postman, technically we call it as a class. If it is a Java application, it will be a Java class. If it is a PHP, then it is a PHP. If it is a Salesforce, then it is an Apex class. Okay. So class or a controller. Technically we call it as this postman, we call it as controller. So it is basically a Java class or Apex class. Just a few minutes. So Java class or Apex class. It is a Java application, we use any technology. This breakup is common for any technology. Then database, Salesforce has not released any articles about database, but it is believed that Salesforce is Oracle DB. But in order to query the data, we have a language called SOQL. Similar to sequential query language, it is Salesforce object query language. Clear? So these are the technologies. If it is classic, then it is Visual Force. If it is Lightning, then we have Lightning tags. Okay. So if it is Lightning, then we have Lightning. At the end of the day, front end is a markup language. It will be similar to HTML. And Apex class will be similar to Java, and no need to worry about. Srikant, do I need to learn Java in order to learn Apex? No, not required. We will be discussing the pace of our class will be in such a way that no Java background or no developer background is required to learn development. So don't worry about it. So whatever that are required, whatever the old concepts of Java that are required to learn Apex, we will discuss in the class itself. So no need to worry about it. Clear? Okay. So these are the technologies that
you have. Do you have any Salesforce DBS, Srikant, or it's not required?
Salesforce DBA in the sense database administrator roles. So those roles will not be there. Testing roles and Salesforce DBA roles are very, very less. Actually, DBA role is not at all there, and testing the scope of, I mean, you can't expect a role in a newspaper beyond Salesforce testers. It is very less. Thoda kam hai. Fine. Scope of, because testing ke liye we have got few tools which will write test class for us. So no need to, I mean, yeah. These roles are not, actually DB role is not at all available. Test, even for testing as well, as an addition, I'm telling keep Salesforce tester roles be very less. And the roles you can find in the market is Salesforce admin. In the sense, there will be a person in the hospital, apart from receptionist, all those things, all the 50 employees who are using our hospital management system, agar kuch error hai toh, small corrections, if a new employee joined the hospital, admin will create a login credentials for that employee. So whether the receptionist was able to see the monetary fields of the patient or not, so all the security issues, all those things admin will take care of it. So admin role will be there. Then if admin is unable to solve the issue na, then the development company, it is in the sense, it is me. So hospital mein there will be some internal admin who will be helping those 50 employees using Salesforce, the receptionist or a doctor or whoever it is. And if he is unable to solve the issue, if the issue is very tough, he will act like a bridge between the hospital and development team, because he's the only one who knows Salesforce in the hospital. Fine. So he'll be acting as a bridge. And agar kuch issue complicated later, then he'll basically take the issue to me and I'll bill it and I'll charge. Yeah, that it goes. So admin, developer, usually these are the most widely found profiles.
No functional or BAs are available in the market for
BA, I mean, Indian market may, yeah, these roles you can find very much, so okay, that you can easily get through into them. But US may have, yeah, I have few US students who are working as business analysts, who are working as testers as well, Salesforce testers as well. Mm-hmm. So here, but yeah, because in whichever the domain, lot of openings are there, we'll try to learn that. Na, I mean, of course,
admin
if
developer.
You learn admin and developer, but if you learn admin and development, na, so thoda sa MBA or prior experience on business analyst, so there is no separate syllabus or requirement for job description for BA. It will be similar to admin itself. I mean, whatever the concepts that we will be learning under the umbrella called admin is the job description for admin, app builder, functional consultant, technical consultant, business analyst.
Okay,
whatever the concepts that we'll be discussing under this umbrella in our training is the job description for all these roles. For anything that doesn't require code, I personally consider it as admin. And I teach the same in the admin.
Okay.
So, any doubts from anyone? Akhil, Nikhil, Ranganath, anyone? Okay then. Okay.
Yeah, I'm good.
Okay then. So, thanks for your time. Guys, have a nice day. And I think that's it from my side. So okay then, thanks for your time, thanks for your patience.
All right.
Have a nice day. All right. And bye bye.
Yeah, thanks Rikan.
Thank you so much.
Thanks everyone. Bye.
Yeah.